Class 9. Last day I have told you what delta is. Today I will tell you how many types of delta are there. There are three types of delta. Accurate delta, acuity delta, Biot-Schur delta and Coskay delta. Accurate delta is a triangular delta which is Greek alphabet delta sign. That is the Brahmaputra delta. You can see it is in a triangular form. Ganga Brahmaputra delta. Apart from this, it is also known as triangular fan-shaped delta. What happens in the bird foot delta? The delta is formed as a bird foot. This delta looks like a bird foot because there are several main branches that extend into the sea like the foot of a bird. The other name of it is digitate delta. Next time, the Cascade delta. This is the delta where the river leaves the sediment onto the straight shoreline along with strong wind. As I have told in Esther, what happens, the river is now flowing firstly, tides comes and wash away the sediments. From an accretion and propagation of sand and shingle, they extend outwards. Like they are not forming inside, they are not forming in the sand. They go outside and it comes in the form of a teeth. So, near the mouth of the river. So, it is it looks like a teeth. So, it has this name. This can be found in Ebro River in Spain. For the formation of delta, some favorable conditions should be there. That is, the upper course of the river should be vertical and lateral corrosion should occur there so that it gets supplies of sediments. The course should be tideless and sheltered. The rate and removal loading of the removal of the load to the sea should be less than in the rate of deposition. That means it shouldn't be washed away. The sediment should be deposited in the mouth of the river. The sea which through where it is adjoined, the delta should be shallow. That means it should be not deep. So that easy washing away of the sediments is not possible. Next, the river should have large number of tributaries so that it can supply load. The river should be long enough to bring large amount of load to the mouth. No large lakes should be there in the course of the rivers because if there is lake, the sediments will be drained out there. The river should not come in contact with strong waves near the mouth of the mouth. Otherwise, the sediments will be washed away. The slopes of the coastal area should be gentle so that it enables the river to become sluggish and deposit sediments there. There should be minimum mixing of fresh water. Much of the fresh water shouldn't be mixed up there from other sources of the river mouth. And saline water of the sea helps in the formation of dirt. Okay. This is an important question. What are the favorable conditions of delta? So, you have to learn this point. So, learn it properly.